Number one album or Man United winning the Premier League next season? Oh, that's disgusting, that question. Yo people, it's your boy H. I'm here with Kiss and this is Back to the Start. Let's go. The first record I listened to or bought was probably Get Rich or Die Trying. I think it was just naturally the first rapper I ever like took in. You know what I'm saying? Like, yeah, I can't remember listening to anyone before 50 Cent. UK-wise, it would have been Chip. But yeah, Get Rich. And it's just, they're just undeniable bangers on there. There's still not been a better album been made since. First big live performance in my early stages was when, I think it was Wireless, and Polo G was meant to be at Wireless, but he must have backed out last minute. And it was on that day, and just by chance, I was in London, and we got a phone call saying, yo, Wireless, someone's dropped out of Wireless. They're saying, can you be on main stage for like 5 o'clock? And it was like 4 o'clock. And we was like 20 minutes away from like where Wireless was. We was like, oh, come, let's just get in the car now. We got in the car, hit the traffic, got out on, I don't even know what road it is, and just ran up the road for about 20 minutes. I was sweating. Got to the stage, came on, sick, and came off, and then that was it. Finished my day, but that was a good little experience. That like kind of like taught me a couple of things. But yeah, I've had plenty of shows. It was just like, it kind of like taught me like to take every opportunity, because that definitely like made a difference to my career. Like, just even the fact of, because I weren't even on the lineup, you know what I'm saying? I filled in for Polo G, but just the reception that I got. And then I think I ended up coming out with, for AJ Tracer at the time. But this was before me and AJ even had a relationship, before we made Rain, whatever. So it was good. It was good. It done a lot for me. That was me probably filling in for Polo G that day was the reason. Probably me and AJ's like friendship started, and maybe we wouldn't have done what we've done if that never happened. So yeah, I only had one job. I was labouring for a couple, like maybe just under a year, and then I blew up, and then I didn't have to work again. If it wasn't for music, I'd probably be. It's absolutely completely left or completely right, and I would be like a PE teacher. Oh, I'd just be on the roads now. My first love interest. I think I've had one girlfriend in my life. I fell in love in like 2019 and fell out of it faster. Growing up in Manchester, I would not want to grow up anywhere else. It's the best city in the world. I feel like it makes me who I am today. It's most of the reason that I'm in a position where I'm in today, because of my funny accent to you lot. And yeah, it's just an amazing place. Well, obviously, it's not the nicest place in the world. At the same time, it's not the worst place in the world. It's good balance. My first song that popped off was Straight Rhymes. That was just like, that's when I blew up. That was what everyone was listening to at the time. And then my next like biggest song since that was like Taste. And then my next biggest song after that was Rain, I think. I've been in the game for 4 years now. They was my three bangers, the one bangers a year. That was, the, you know what I'm saying, the biggest ones. Baby. Hopefully, I'm talking from the past here, but hopefully, Baby's my fourth year banger. If not, I've got another one I can drop after, don't worry, I'm not stressing. I put Straight Rhymes out on my YouTube channel to just start my YouTube channel off and hopefully get a couple hundred subscribers so I could then post my next single on my YouTube channel. And Straight Rhymes just blew it all out of the water, and I never released that next single, and I don't even know where that song is to this day. The best career advice someone has given me would probably be, I don't know, there's a couple of things. I don't know, this isn't even career advice, this is just probably like general advice, but it does help with your career. Just treat people how you want to be treated, innit? I think, I mean, things always come back around. Relationship advice, just do what makes you happy, innit? You know what I'm saying? I think that's the whole thing of a relationship, like understand the other person's, what makes the other person happy, understand what makes you happy. If you're not happy, then obviously something's not right. Number one album or Man United winning the Premier League next season? Oh, that's disgusting, that question. Number one album is what it is. Number one album, but I would like to change it. I would like to change that. I want a platinum album. I don't care about whatever number it is when it's called platinum, but I also want United to win the Premier League. But yeah, I'll go for the album. Growing up, Rooney, Scholes and Ronaldo. Can't really tell you between them three. But it changes different times. Robin Van Persie was one of my favourite United players while he was there. But yeah, Ronaldo, Rooney and Scholes, they're the main three. Supporting Man United back in the day was the best times of my life. We never used to lose. Being a Man United fan over the years has been sick. Probably like for the past like 5 years now, it's been a bit of a struggle, but I don't know. It'll turn around. We'll be back one day. I've been saying this for 5 years now. I don't know when that day is going to come. Future goals. Platinum album. Just more success. Take over some more places, some more countries and whatnot. Try and get my name out there in the States a bit more. Obviously everywhere in Europe. And just be happy, just always be happy. Stay on my feet and just stay on top, stay happy, stay working. And make sure my family's all good. Oh, we don't care about anything else, to be honest. And make sure United win the league. There's not much I can do about that though. I think my younger self would say to me now, like, oh yeah, you've been waiting for this, innit? Kind of thing, like, yeah, this was meant to happen. But also, it would also be like, yeah, wow, well done. But yeah, I don't know. I never really thought about it too much, to be fair. I'm just going with the flow still. Ask me that again in 10 years. Pull this clip out. So now we're watching this now. It's now 2033. Ask me this question again, and I'll have a better answer for you. B-B-B-B-B-B-B-K. Kiss.